So earlier tonight, my husband John and I went to our favorite restaurant, Poppy's.
Oh, so now we've learned the place that they were actually at, okay? So Cindy's blog carries on. We were pleasantly surprised to find that the head chef, Poppy himself, has added two new dishes to the menu. So that's pretty cool. And maybe they've been told that, or maybe they've been there before and they go, oh, this is new. This wasn't here last time. What have we got?
Okay. So yesterday we talked about the chef being the person at the restaurant, and the head chef is usually the person who decides the items on the menu.
Yeah, and kind of does the first kind of cooking and then trains the other chefs, I would guess. Something like that. So, they've got these new dishes on the menu. What else do we see in the article?
And then it says, we are both in agreement that these are the most exceptional dishes he offers now. So there are a couple phrases here. One is, be in agreement with. So if you're in agreement with someone, for example, I'm in agreement with Pat, that means we think the same thing. You can also use the idiom, we are on the same page, or we agree with each other, or I also agree with your opinion. So that's be in agreement. So the second phrase is exceptional.
Yeah, exceptional is an adjective and it means really high quality. We talk about exceptional things because they stand out from the other things of the same kind. If somebody watched a really great movie and they're like, oh, this is the best superhero movie or the best James Bond movie I've seen, so we say that's an exceptional movie. It's better than almost all the other kind of James Bond or superhero movies like it. It's definitely one of the best ones.
So this word is like accept, right? It's like stands out from the rest.
Yeah, it's kind of above or beyond. We can also use the noun. It's an exception. It's different from the others, often because it's better.
Have you seen any exceptional movies lately?
Not recently, I have to say, but I don't go to the movies as much anymore, so I can't remember seeing anything that I thought, wow, that's really amazing.
Black Panther, everybody, if you haven't seen.
That was very good. I'll agree with that.
All right. So then in the article, it says John selected the Kobe beef steak, which was one of the best beef dishes we've ever tried.
Wow, that does sound pretty good.
Very exceptional, because best ever is like top of the top, right?
So about that beef dish, Cindy says, yes, it's a luxury, but it's not something you have the chance to try every day. So she describes the beef dish as a luxury. And a luxury, as a noun, is something a person doesn't really need, but it's really nice to have or enjoy. And we generally use it to refer to something that's expensive and high quality. So they're saying, well, we're not going to eat Kobe beef every day, but when you get a chance to try it, wow, it is so good. Now, we can also use the word luxury as a modifier to a noun. For example, we could talk about a luxury hotel. That means a really high quality, expensive, really nice hotel. Here's another example. The mother makes sure her children know that chocolate is a luxury, not something they can eat whenever they want. That was definitely how chocolate was for me. My mum would say, what? No, chocolate's for special days. Maybe you can have some because it's Sunday. That's it. You can't get it every day.
Not whenever you want, for sure. So then the article says, the thin, tender slices of beef just melted in our mouths. So that sounds really good. So when we say something melts in our mouths, it means it goes into your mouth and it just dissolves, like it becomes water. You can't even really like chew or bite because you don't need to. So it just melts in your mouth. So that's really, really high quality food. So an example sentence would be, Pat, my ice cream is melting. Help me finish it.
Okay, so yeah, melt, if you talk about ice melting, it just turns into water. But melting in your mouth is just, the food is really kind
so
of
good.
Soft, tasty. It just sort of all the flavors come out and you don't need to chew it for a long time, anything like that. So yeah, that does sound really good. Even though I don't eat meat, I'm thinking of the idea of this Kobe beef dish and thinking that does sound good. Now, Cindy then adds, they, so that's the slices of beef, were served with a slice of lemon, which is how it's served in Japan. So again, we've kind of used they, the beef slices, but we also use the pronoun it to mean the whole dish. So don't worry about the use of two different pronouns in there. They are referring to two slightly different things. So yeah, putting some lemon with beef. Now again, I don't eat meat. Is that normal?
I don't usually think they put lemon with beef, usually with fish or something.
Yeah, yeah, fish or seafood, yes, but beef, yeah. Okay, that is interesting then.
I'd like to try it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and then the article says, this gave it a very distinctive taste. So here we have the word distinctive. Distinctive is an adjective, and it means different or unique, nothing like anything else you've seen. So for example, if you say,I really like that girl's distinctive style. It's very feminine, but sometimes a bit masculine. So we have two kind of complicated words here. What do these words mean? Feminine means female, right? So similar to what a girl would wear. So an example of something feminine could be wearing a dress, having a braid, wearing a color pink.But then sometimes this girl's style is a bit masculine. So masculine starts with M, that sounds like male. So something that would be a little more masculine would be a pair of ripped jeans, loose jeans, boyfriend jeans. We call these baggy shirt. So maybe this girl pairs up a braid with like some loose jeans. And it's very distinctive because you look at her and you're like, wow, that's interesting. She's different from everyone else.
So in the blog, Cindy then moves on to say, I had the new clam pasta with pesto sauce. Remember, that's the green sauce with a bit of basil and garlic and kind of cheese and olive oil with the clams, those kind of seafood stuff.
Oh, sounds so good. And then it says, apparently Poppy makes the sauce every day with specialty ingredients imported from Italy. So what are these specialty ingredients? When we use the word special ingredients as a noun, specialty refers to an item that is in a region that's really famous for that item, but you can't always find it in other places. So for example, a specialty sauce, sriracha, specialty sauce for pho from Vietnam. And what other specialties do we have?
You could talk about Alishan tea.
Ah!
It's a specialty of the Alishan area.
High mountain.
That kind of thing. Yeah, sure. Okay, so we already mentioned ingredients, and we know that the chef Poppy's making this fresh sauce every day. And like we said yesterday, these ingredients are imported. So that's using the adjective form of import to mean it's coming in from another country.And on that subject, Cindy then says, did I mention the Kobe beef is also flown in from Japan?
Ooh.
So this phrase, fly in, if you're talking about you, you say, I just flew in from somewhere, it means you've gone somewhere in an airplane. Here we've used the passive voice, the beef is flown in from somewhere, and it means it's brought to somewhere by plane, okay?We use this phrase as another way to describe that the beef is imported, it's from another country, and we just use flown in because, of course, it's coming in by plane, so that means it's going to be quicker than a boat, so it's going to be super fresh when it arrives. Maybe they didn't even have to freeze it, they just kind of were able to get it there really quickly so they could cook with the fresh beef.
Fancy.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and then the article says, if I have any complaints, it's that the Kobe beef dish is traditionally Japanese. That is, it's not much food, even with the side salad. All right, so here Cindy has a complaint. A complaint is something that you're not too happy with. In this case, the complaint is a written or spoken statement, which is something that you can write in a blog or tell the restaurant, in which somebody says that they're not completely satisfied with something. So an example sentence would be, the customer filed a complaint against the restaurant because there was a cockroach in her food.
Oh, okay. Disgusting. Yeah, I've actually had that happen to us before.
Me too.
Yeah, we did get a free meal though, so, you know, they were very nice about it. Now, Cindy also used the phrase, that is. She said, it's a traditional Japanese dish. That is, it wasn't much food. And we can use the phrase, that is, at the start of a sentence or the start of a clause, because we're going to use it to explain something in a different or an often clearer way. It could be kind of the same as using because. Okay, it's a traditional Japanese dish, and because it's a traditional Japanese dish, there's not much food. Another way to say it would be therefore instead of that is. It's a traditional Japanese dish, therefore there's not much food. So that is just another variation on that kind of language.
I kind of find that is and therefore is usually used in more writing rather
yes.
than speaking. It's yes. a little bit more formal.
Yeah.
So usually we say because when we're talking, but she's writing a blog, so it's a bit formal. All right, and then in the article, she continues to go on and say, if you ordered it, I'd recommend getting it with one of Poppy's baked potatoes. So that was a side dish that goes really well together, according to Cindy. So if you guys go to the restaurant, that's what you have to try it with, too. So here we have the word recommend. Recommend here is used as a verb, and that means to make a suggestion. The noun form is recommendation, and you can also say make a recommendation. So an example sentence would be, I recommend the honey lavender ice cream. It's my favorite. Or I would like to make a recommendation for the honey lavender ice cream. It's my favorite.
Actually, that does sound like a pretty good recommendation. I will take that honey lavender ice cream. Okay, so there, the recommendation that Cindy made was get a side salad, sure, but also get a baked potato.
Ooh, that sounds so good.
Yeah, now a baked potato is when you get the potato and you kind of poke it with a fork a few times, but then you put it in an oven and you bake it. And sometimes you can bake it for like 2 hours if the heat isn't too hot.So that when it comes out, the skin is very hard, kind of crunchy, but inside all the potato is cooked and it's soft. You kind of split it open, put some salt, some cheese in there.
Butter,
of course, bits of bacon. In the UK, we would call this a jacket potato because the potato skin is kind of like a thick jacket that the potato is wearing. And that's one thing that I don't often eat and see in menus in Taiwan. So whenever I go home to the UK, I kind of make sure my mum will get me a jacket potato at some point with plenty of butter, cheese, and baked beans in tomato sauce.
Oh, it sounds good. So good. That's But, definitely on the menu for your
yeah,
restaurant.
Yeah, that is, yes. But I do know that in Taipei, we have the Texas Roadhouse restaurant.
Oh.
And if people go there and get some of the steaks, they almost always have a baked potato with it.So, yeah, that kind of goes well together. And in fact, as Cindy says in the next sentence about ordering a baked potato, she says, I suppose that's very American, but it does go perfectly with beef. So the same potato, jacket potato, and beef steak go well together. She is saying it kind of sounds American, like the Texas Roadhouse. It does sound like a Western-style thing. Japan wouldn't have potatoes and meat in that kind of way.Now there, Cindy also said suppose. Suppose as a verb can be used to mean guess, like I suppose, I guess, or you can use it to say something without much proof. Also, you can use it to admit something, but with a little bit of hesitation because we're not quite sure we're right. We could use this verb suppose to make a suggestion, like I suppose we could go to the movies tonight.Like it's a sort of suggestion. So she's saying, well, yeah, okay, I'll admit it sounds a bit American, but they go well together. So here's another example of suppose. I suppose the quickest way to get there is by taxi. So she doesn't know, the speaker doesn't know that for sure. They're just kind of making a guess and also a bit of a suggestion. Yeah, I think we could do that. Get there by taxi. That's the quickest way.
So Pat says, I suppose is not really sure. So next
yeah.
time if you ask somebody a question and they say, I suppose, don't assume that they actually mean yes.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so in the article she continues to say, still, I absolutely recommend both dishes. Absolutely. So here, absolutely is an adverb. And when you say, I absolutely recommend it, it means I'm super sure, I definitely love it, you must do this, and I'm so sure that it's awesome.
Yeah, 100% kind of thing.
Yep.
And that brings us to the end of our blog, so it's now time for today's For You Chat question.